Luke chapter 24, and we shall see the tasks. It's the same thing that he's expounding the tasks little by little. I'm taking verse 45 from 45 for a specific reason. Luke 24 from 45. Then opened he their understanding that they might understand the scriptures. Number one, you need to understand the scriptures. And the only person that can open your understanding is the Holy Spirit. And said unto them, thus it is written, and thus it behoved Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day. We must understand that Christ had to suffer, that Christ had to be killed, and that Christ had to be raised up again. And go and tell them that, and verse 1 says, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. For you and I, start in your own Jerusalem. Start in your household. Start in your community. Start in your neighborhood. Don't think of taking the gospel to America, taking it to Europe, taking it to Australia, those fine places. We craftily avoid the Middle East. We cunningly avoid China and the places where they are beheading Christians. But we want to go to those places where there is sunshine and enjoyment. Go there and preach repentance and remission of sins. And in verse 14 it says, and ye are witnesses of these things. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you will be a witness of these things. You will be able to witness about these things. And in 49 it says, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. Wait until you are endued. Matthew 28. Matthew 28. And I'm going to be reading verse 19 and 20. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. I'm going to be with you. Go and teach all nations. Other than just say, go and make disciples. The way to make disciples is to do what? To teach. So as you preach, you bring them in. And when they are coming, what do? You teach. To make them to become disciples. No, you're not the one making them to be disciples. As you teach the word of God, with the Holy Spirit there, the Lord Jesus will make them his disciples. They are not there to serve you. They are there to serve you. God may make them to do one or two things for you, but that doesn't mean that they are servants. They are God's servants primarily. Mark chapter 16, from verse 15 to verse 20. Mark 16, 15 to 20. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. We're not talking of preaching to dogs now. We're talking of every human being. So you can see that nobody is exempt from hearing the gospel. People of every tribe, of every nation, of every religion, of every creed. Preach it. He that believeth, he has told you, not everybody will believe. So he says, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. But he that believeth not shall be damned. But what are you to do? Go and preach. Leave them to believe or not to believe. You go and preach. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. God is not asking you to see poison and go and drink it. But if for any reason somebody poisons you unwittingly without your knowledge, he will not harm you. If they do juju for you, so what? You wouldn't even know. You won't harm you. Don't go start thinking about who's doing juju. No, that's not your business. Let them do what they want to do. It will fail. Verse 19. So then, after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord walking with them and confirming the word with signs following. Who was walking with them now? The Lord. years, W-O-R-K, was working with them and not with them. God is not going to leave you without His presence, without His support. Indeed, I've said this over and over again. The work of God can only be done by God, which is why we have been given the Holy Spirit to help us to do His work. The Holy Spirit is given to us so that you and I can do the work of God in a manner that is acceptable to Him.